time, you're going to need help for the harvest. Amen. You're going to need help for the harvest. In Jesus' name. Because it is our season of divine encounter. As we encounter God, something will give. Praise the Lord. Something is going to give. The toil will give. The back-breaking work will give. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name. Verse 12. While Jesus was in one of the towns, a man came along who was covered with leprosy. When he saw Jesus, he fell with his face to the ground and begged him, "Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean." Jesus reached out his hand and touched the man. "I am willing," he said, "be clean." And immediately the leprosy left him. Then Jesus ordered him, "Don't tell anyone, but go show yourself to the priest and offer the sacrifices that Moses commanded for your cleansing as a testimony to them." Yet the news about him spread all the more, hallelujah, so that crowds of people came to hear him and be healed of their sicknesses. But Jesus often withdrew to lonely places and prayed. May God bless the reading of his word.
Amen.
Hallelujah. An encounter with Jesus will restore all long-standing problems. Praise the Lord. We'll resolve them. This man was a man full of leprosy. But when he had that encounter with Jesus, immediately, praise the Lord, immediately, hallelujah. One thing that I want to bring out to us is this, that there were two boats, and Jesus picked one. So, two boats, one was chosen in the same vicinity. But you see, but at the end of that encounter, there were fishermen, so that boat was a walk to. Praise the Lord. It's like a computer for most of us, because that's where we do a lot of our work. In the olden days, it is pen for the people who write. But you see, that is their walk to. That is the thing that they used to do their job. That is their livelihood that they had been using and not bringing any results. So now one was picked and was launched into the boat. But the thing is this, that there was enough fish so that the other boat was also able to be a part of it. So when the encounter, when we encounter Jesus, it is never an encounter for just ourselves. It is never. God is not in the business of I, me, and myself. Praise the Lord. He's not. He's in the business of ensuring that what he has is distributed to all that are around him. Which is why when people were hungry, the 5 loaves and 2 fish was multiplied to feed 5,000. It wasn't like, okay, half of you, we only have a little now, it can only feed 2 people, so how are we going to do it now? Okay, because you are older, okay, the men, no food for you. We'll start with the children and feed only the children because we don't, no, God is not in the business of not enough. He is the El Shaddai. He's in the business of ensuring that it reaches everywhere. So their boats, one boat was full, so they called the partner, come. So the fact that you might be somewhere with somebody and God picks the other person does not mean that you have lost out. Praise the Lord. So what I'm trying to say is that in this season of divine encounter, don't allow selfishness to get at you. Because when God has blessed you, That blessing is not for you alone. You must share it. And while you're staying where you are, and it looks as if God has chosen somebody else, do not allow the spirit of envy. Hallelujah. Don't allow the spirit of envy to truncate your destiny. Because you see, you will get it. Amen. The fact that somebody has gone to do, you see, that person went to do the work, caught the fish, and then needed some help. Praise the Lord. And therefore calls the partner. So what if the partners were a bit angry and said, it is Peter's boat that, you know, this man who has been talking that we've come to listen to, is Peter's boat that they asked for. We're not interested. Let's just leave. Let's just go. We're not going to be here. What is this? They would not have been part of the blessing. And that is what happens a lot of the times. When God blesses and, you know, it's like, I'm not part of it. I'm not this, I'm not that. People just dust themselves, you know, and they just walk away. And therefore miss their blessing. Miss the place of their assignment. That is not our portion in Jesus' name. Amen. This our season of divine encounter. Each and every one of us will be a partaker of what God has destined for us. Irrespective of where he starts. Irrespective of where he starts. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. And if God does not start with us, God will give us the grace to stay where we are. Because we know that it will reach us in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So there was more than enough for the two boats. Hallelujah. But you see, what actually also caught my eye, let's look at it again. Praise the Lord. What the Holy Spirit brought to my attention concerning the boat issue was this. Let me start from verse 7. So they signaled to their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came. And they filled both boats so that they began to sink. Hallelujah. Now, verse 11. So they pulled their boats on the shore, left everything, and followed him. Praise the Lord. They pulled their boats to the shore. They left everything and followed him. They left everything. And what caught my eye was that rather than grab the blessing, they went after the giver. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Says, no matter how much fish there was in the boat, it will finish. No matter how much. Praise the Lord. But I said that if we follow Christ, who can bring something out of nothing,
yes,
we will never run out.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, Hebrews 11:3 says, by faith, we see the world called into existence by God's word. What we see created by what we don't see. What we see being created by what we don't see. That's the Message version. Hallelujah. The one who is able to make something out of nothing, if you follow him, you will never lack. Which is why they were confident in living. They had toiled. Look, let's just think about this. This is something they had toiled all night for. That is, the fish in the boat is something they had been working all night for. They got, Jesus comes and performs a miracle. Just like that. Two boats are almost sinking. They drag the boats to the shore. When he now tells him, don't worry, they are, you know, hailing him, Jesus, Jesus. He says, this is a small thing. Don't worry, you will soon become fishers of men. He says that they left everything and followed him. They were fishing because that was their livelihood. That was the way they make their living. That is how they would make money to eat, to feed their families, to live in their homes, to clothe themselves, to meet their needs. But what They left everything and followed him because they know that he is the source. And whatever it is that they need, he will provide. The fish they will sell to make money. If it is house, he will give them. If it is brothers and sisters, he says you will fish men, he will give them. Praise the Lord. If it is money, he will give them. Clothes, he will give them. This ties in with the word that God gave us today, that we need not chase after all, you know, what we will eat, what we will drink, what we will wear. That is what the pagans chase after. It says that God chase after God. It says that he knows what you need. Your heavenly Father knows that you have need of them. God is in the business of meeting people's needs. Praise the Lord. He is in the business of meeting people's needs. There are a lot of things that we want, but they are not.